What's up, everyone? Today I'm going to give you a tour of Orlando International Airport. Right now I'm looking at the Terminal C building, which is not yet open to the public. It's supposed to open later in September, but for now the only terminals that are open are terminals A and B, and I'll have to make my way over there. I'm in the Terminal C parking lot. And I need to make my way over to the People Mover, which will take me to Terminal A and B. I needed to park over here because the other parking lot was completely full. That's the train station, the SunRail, and this is the overpass that I need to take to get to the People Mover. The Terminal C building should be very nice once it opens to the public, but Terminals A and B are very nice already. The airport code for this airport is MCO, which is a reference to the former name of the airport, the McCoy Air Force Base. It used to be a strategic military base. Right. Terminals A and B, as well as the train station, is here. And they also have the signage for the Bright Line as well, which is the high-speed rail service that's expected to come to Orlando sometime in 2023. There's a People Mover coming. Okay, we made it just in time. Departs every 4 minutes, it says. I guess we're gonna have a front row seat here.
Please watch your step.
Very clean.
Next stop, terminals A and B.
There's also a Hyatt Regency Airport.
Please stand clear of doors and hold on to
handrails.
The doors are now closing. Please stand clear of doors and hold on to handrails. The doors are now closing. The APN is now departing. Please hold on to the handrails. The next stop is terminals A and B.
Hello, this is Orlando Mayor Buddy Dyer, and welcome to the future of Central Florida travel. This automated e-commerce system is the latest in high-tech engineering and is designed to create seamless ground air transportation, providing you with your Orlando experience.
This people mover will take people to the rail station.
Please stand clear of doors and hold onto handrails. When the APN stops, please exit to terminals A and B. The doors are now opening. Please exit to terminals A and B. Please watch your step.
Very nice. I'm very excited for the airport when Terminal C finally does open. But for now, let's explore Terminal A and B. I heard this airport is very modern and even features a water fountain. Here's all the airlines that serve terminals A and B. Looks like this is a TSA security checkpoint over to my right. And we are now here. This is Orlando International Airport. This is my first time at this airport, and my first impressions are, wow, I'm impressed. What airport has a water fountain in the middle like this with a sky roof? And terminals B and A are clearly marked. Here's the Hyatt Regency Hotel, which is incorporated into the airport itself. The rooms are just above us. Orlando is a United States tourist destination for theme parks and Disney, and seems like this airport is even like a theme park in and out of itself. And there's a lot to lot of stuff to see right before the security checkpoint. There's a bunch of stores here. There's a food court as well. Most airports I've been to, the food court isn't even accessible until after you pass TSA. But there's an entire shopping mall inside this airport. No wonder why there was no free parking in A and B, or the parking garage is full. This sculpture looks so realistic. Bronze sculpture, The Traveler, Davie, Florida. This is such an amazing airport. There's even an aquarium right in the middle of the food court. There's also postal services available. And I also like how there's a lot of seats available for everybody. I don't even know if I'm in Terminal A or Terminal B right now. This is like the shopping mall section, I guess. Another sky roof. More security screening. Hi. Big clock here. I guess we're in Terminal A now. Let's go downstairs. JetBlue baggage claim. There's some seating available here, but not as much as I hoped. I think something's wrong with their fire system. The alert over there just keeps flashing and ringing. Let me get out of here. This fire alarm is so annoying. But if you order a rideshare service, Uber or Lyft, you can catch them right here. This is where the Ubers and Lyfts will pick up people. Arrivals level. Let's go back up and walk over to Terminal B. I'm glad I didn't fly into Orlando or checking out of Orlando, because look at that security line. Even a Disney store inside the airport. Magic of Disney. Looks to be a similar setup to Terminal A's baggage claim. Let's go check the check-in area now. Very busy on this side. Probably goes all the way down to the water fountain area that we were at before. American Airlines is super busy. I guess Saturday afternoon is a popular time to fly. But this was the area that impressed me the most in the airport. The central courtyard with the Hyatt Regency Hotel. In fact, I'm a little bit curious. What happens if I take the elevator to the hotel lobby? Is there even a hotel lobby here? Okay, watch the airplanes take off, enjoy the Florida sunshine at the only in-terminal outdoor pool in Orlando. I guess level 4. I'm curious what the lobby of this hotel looks like now. Okay, we are at the lobby of the in-terminal Hyatt Regency Hotel. Oh my gosh. Glad I took a trip up here. This hotel is a masterpiece. Let's take a look at the other restaurant. Day rates available too at this hotel. You know, I could have taken this escalator up instead of the elevator. It went right to the lobby. And here's McCoy's restaurant inside the hotel. There's a piano in the back. They even have model airplanes in display cases. You can take a look at them. It's a business lounge. And an overview of the courtyard from the second floor. All right, everyone. I'm going to end my video of the Orlando International Airport here. I was really blown away at the magnitude of this airport and what it had to offer inside. But if you enjoy this video, then hit that like button for me. Subscribe if you haven't already to the channel, and I will see you next time. Bye, everyone. See you later.